the best family on YouTube. Good morning, y'all. Today's gonna be a good day because I said it's a good day. Oh my God, Yousef was so sad yesterday. He must be bipolar. Oh my God, I am. What's up, everybody? So I am bipolar, guys. Here's my medication. So your comments that you think are so witty, this guy's bipolar, make me laugh. But bipolar isn't what everybody makes it out to be. It's not one second like, hey, and the next second, hey. It's deeper than that. It's deeper than that. So today I woke up and I've been feeling so good. I went to the gym, I got my workout in, I ate a good breakfast, I was dancing during traffic, listening to J. Cole, and I told myself, you know what? Just smile today, just be happy, and I'm gonna do a challenge for you guys. This is gonna be the hardest thing I've ever done in my entire life. Today, I am not allowed to spend more than 30 minutes in my apartment at a time. And I can't just leave, come back. That means right now when I go to my therapist meeting, which I'm about to be late to, I can't come home after. I have to go find something to do. I'm not gonna do this every day, but let's just do it today.
No such thing.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing.
Heart beating fast, let a nigga know that he alive. Fake niggas, man, snakes in the grass, let a nigga know that he arrived. Don't be sleeping on your level, cause it's beauty in the struggle, nigga. What's wrong?
There's beauty in the struggle, ugliness in the success.
Just left my therapy meeting and I'm feeling beautiful. It's a beautiful day. Can't complain. Got the window open. Got the sun shining. I'm happy, so that's all that matters. I love you guys, and yeah. So normally I would have already gone home, but you guys know today's challenge, so I can't. But I already broke my watch. Rolexes don't have batteries, so you have to like spin them if you didn't wear it for 48 hours, or else the time stops. My time stopped, I tried to fix it, I messed up, so I'm just gonna go in there so they can fix the time already, and yeah.
So normally, because of how much I love to be isolated, I have an issue telling people I wanna see them because it's just not something that I'm good at. But today, because I knew I had to be out all day, I texted the weird girl and I told her, I wanna see you, and I don't do that. Like, I'm not because like an ego standpoint or anything, but that's just because it's hard for me, and I haven't told someone I wanted to see them in a long time, but I texted her, so I'm going to pick her up right now.
What's up, y'all? So I'm still outside, haven't gone to my house today yet, but I did drop off my car. I'm with the weird girl. What's up? I'll say this though, the weird girl, no, I was about to say who you look like, but if I tell them who you look like, they'll find you one way or another. She looks like a famous celebrity. Like when I'm out with her, I think people think that I'm with a celebrity.
People have been saying Kylie Jenner though, and I don't look like her, so.
You do not look like Kylie Jenner.
So scratch that idea, y'all.
Who the hell said that? Oh, they said it in the vlogs?
Everybody.
Kylie Jenner?
Everybody thinks you're with
Yeah, bro, I'm kicking it with Kylie Jenner right now.
And they all think I'm a minor, so they're like putting it together. Definitely not a minor.
She's not a minor. She's not Kylie Jenner. But she does look like a celebrity. And I know a lot of y'all are still mad over the fact that I don't show her. Some people are like, yo, just stop vlogging her. Well, I still want to hang out with her, but I just not on camera. So it's like, it's the best that I can do. Anyways, we're making a walk right now. We're walking to the Grove because I was so sick of driving. So I'm just enjoying the day. You know, sober living out here. What you laughing about? Let's go. So if you guys didn't notice, she loves to eat. All she does is eat. So we're at Subway right now. I'm kidding, by the way. I'm the one who tells you to go eat, but we're at Subway. I love the smell. Huh? Therefore, she's not anorexic, because some people in the comments said she was anorexic. She eats a lot. I can respect that. So we're at Subway. I'm gonna wait and rest and then continue our walk to the Grove. So as we're walking, I see this. and I own all the seasons, so I was telling her how I have to go see it, and she goes, what's Entourage? What's Entourage?
Dude, I know what it is. I'm just like, I've never seen it.
Now you know now you know what it is?
I wouldn't get it.
Now you know what it is? What is it? Say it loud enough so they can hear you. What is it as you eat your Subway?
A TV show.
What a piece of shit. Alright, she knows what it is. But I wanted to see it. But she don't want to see it.
I didn't say I didn't want to. I said, that man will see.
So I'm going to go see Entourage and enjoy it. Because I've been waiting for that movie for a long time. So we just walked into Undefeated. She was hating on my Toms. I don't see anything wrong with Toms, but the only reason I decided to come in here was because we were walking hella far and I didn't like being in the Toms, and I just saw these. I don't care what you like, alright? So I actually do like them though, so I think I'm about to get them and get out of these Toms. I think I'm about to get a whole different outfit because I'm just not happy with what I'm wearing right now. So I'm about to get a shirt too. Watch me. Watch me. I like them. I'm about to get them. I don't like the shirt though, so I might change out of the shirt. I bought a completely different outfit. I just wasn't comfortable, and it's crazy how much a different outfit makes you feel like a different person. Like in that outfit, I felt sophisticated. In this outfit, I just feel like, you know? But the fact that I could just buy a shirt and wear now and it fits me. Ow. Ah. My pimple. So the adventures continue. We just jumped in an Uber and now we're going to the Grove. But now the sucky part is I have to carry this bag the whole time because I did the whole outfit switch, but it's all good. So we're gonna go to the Grove. Guys, look, it's Dollar's brother.
But he's 3 years old, but he's the same size as Dollar.
Mason.
Yeah, my guy won't grow.
Oh yeah?
At all, and everyone. Oh my God.
That's how he was. I mean, his mom and dad were almost twice that big.
We're in Topshop because I needed some booty shorts. But these are a little too, like, I feel like I don't have enough room right here. So what do you think? Nah? So I guess I can't go with these. Maybe when I lose more weight and my butt gets a little tighter, I can fit into these. I'm just kidding, guys. She was looking at them. I'm just walking around. Yo, this is hella cute. Come here. If a girl can pull this off, if a girl can pull that off, that's hella cute. All right, girls, if you can pull that off, it's cute. All right, to all you girls who are infatuated with stories like The Notebook and all that, whatever, mumbo jumbo, 50 Shades of Grey and The Fault in Our Stars, my Uber driver right here, can you give him a quick summary of the story that you just told me?
Yes. I met my wife. She was my neighbor, and she was evicted from her place. I took her with me. We rented an apartment. A month later, we got married.
Bruh! So his a girl lived next door to him. She was a babysitter for her aunt. She got kicked out because her aunt and her got in a fight. So then he came outside and was like, what's going on? And she was crying and she told him. He said, come with me. He went, rented an apartment, brought her in. A month later, went to the 99-cent store, got a ring, and then went to the clerk's office and got married. And they were married for 45 years. And he said they were made for each other. Y'all over here talking about, I want relationship goals. I want to match Louis Vuitton's red. That's love, okay? I'm over here struggling and he's finding love with his neighbor. But I already told him me and this girl just got engaged. That's why I brought this whole thing up. I told him I'm 25, she's 21.
Sorry,
we got engaged. And he said, you said we're gonna work, right?
Hell yes.
See? Mm-hmm. Babe, why are you always on your phone? See, we get in fights about that. She's always on her phone.
Oh, that's all right. Yeah, it's a lot different now.
It is different. Girls aren't loyal like they were back then.
Yeah.
Just because I'm on my phone.
Because you're like, you guys, what year was it when you got married?
Loyal to the phone.
Hey. What year was it when you got married?
Let's see. Let's see, we're married 45 years.
1954, man. Take me back to 1954 and let me find that real love. All right, guys, so we just got out of the Uber and he told us his wife passed away. And then out of nowhere, he goes, I have a girlfriend. And I was like, what? I go, how old are you? 74. How old is your girlfriend? 50. I go, how did you meet? He goes, he broke his hip, had to get sent home, had to have a therapist come massage him and stuff, and the therapist fell in love with him.
He's a G.
He's a G.
He's a womanizer. Well, womanizer's bad.
Yeah.
Then he's a...
He's a
charmer.
Charmer.
Not
yeah.
a player. He's not a player.
Yeah, well, he's a charmer. He's a charming man.
Yeah.
I can't believe that. I told him, I was like, well, he thought me and her were engaged, but I was like, I'm 25 and don't have a girlfriend. You're 74 with a girlfriend and she fell in love with you and she's 24 years younger than you. Like, bruh, this guy was doing it.
Can you imagine, like, that's your, if you.
What?
Like your girlfriend would be being born right
I
now.
I know. That's just, oh my God.
Like that'd be you and your girlfriend being born right now.
A baby, yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy. This dude is, this guy, what's funny is I almost canceled the Uber trip because it took him like 20 minutes to find us. But that, like, that was the best thing of my day. That was hella sweet. So I had to come home for a second because I had to eat my lunch. But guys, look at this. Remember the black jeans I always used to wear? Bruh, I'm not trying to show you my balls right now, but look how much space, bruh. Hey, and this is my first time wearing a hat in like months because I've been liking not wearing it, but I wore one right now. But damn. So I changed my outfit again for the final time this time, and I feel comfortable now. You guys, I think the problems that I've been facing, if you guys realize, has been ever since I stopped wearing a hat. So I put my hat back on and I feel better already. Anyways. We didn't know what to do. I wanted to go watch Entourage. She didn't.
Stop saying that. You
damn.
The dark.
Damn, she got mad. Anyways, she taught me this lesson. So I was like, what do you want to do? She was like, Yousef. I said, what's up? She said, just be free. And I was like, all right. So we're outside walking, being free. No destination. I know what's down this road. She doesn't. So we're just walking. I'm being free. Don't gotta worry about where we're going or what we're doing, right?
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I'm just walking. I'm just looking at everything, you know?
Just be free, y'all. So we walked into an art exhibition of this guy named Richard Scholten. So these are his paintings. He has some like look at this. What's really awesome is they give you this iPad, right? And you can like point it at it and that like show go back to it.
Wait.
You did it right, that was
yeah,
it.
Yeah, but how does it go away so you can show it?
So like so that's the painting, right guys? But if you click this, that's as he was painting it. So it shows you where he was working at and where what it turned into. That's awesome. That is awesome.
Yeah. That's crazy.
What's crazier is the price. Like that one right there is $35,000. Which one? What is your interpretation of that one? This is my favorite one right here. It's dope. What's crazy about painting and art, everyone has their own like interpretation of it. Guys, this one is incredible. For me at least, I really, really, really like this one. Unfortunately, it's $65,000. But
60.
Oh, it's $60,000. Oh, now we talking. let me pull out my MasterCard. As you guys know, today I'm doing the I'm not allowed to go home for more than 30 minutes challenge, and I'm loving it. Like I'm just walking right now. I just found a dog park I can take Dollar tomorrow. I'm so excited to come home. I'm so excited for tomorrow because I'm gonna bring Dollar here. There's a lake over there. Life is good. Life is beautiful. It's what I want it to be. And man, guys, like, this is it. Like, what they teach you, what they teach you in like rehab and all this stuff is how to do other things other than your addiction. So like, your addiction is in the circle, and then they put other things like go outside, go hang out with a friend, go read books, go do this. But it's a lot more than that, because when you have an addiction, it's something that's deeply rooted as to why you are the way you are from your childhood. But just to, for the time being, do other things. So me just going out like this and exploring life is so much better than sitting at home, going somewhere, doing my addiction and all that stuff. So life is beautiful right now. Look at that smile. And and life is good, man.
Watch, are you watching me?
What is it?
It's Tri River.
Okay, what is in there?
I don't know.
What am I supposed to be watching? You told me to watch.
Like bubbles. That one just did like a huge bubble.
Okay, I fart in my bathtub and it bubbles too, so.
Well, this is like, we'll have to read the, you're gross. Why did you?
Because bubbles don't.
Like, it just, yeah, it just doesn't happen naturally, so like we have to figure out why.
Why it's doing it?
To read it.
We should find out why it does it, guys. All right, I just ran into a brubra in the cutties. So, what's up?
Oh, what's up?
He says he watches the vlogs.
I sure do, every week.
Should we test them on it?
Go ahead.
What do I call the audience?
Damn, that's a good one.
All right, no. He did say my dog, though. He did say what kind of dog I had.
Turkey.
Yeah. So I appreciate that. I appreciate the support.
Nice to see you, bro.
And I was telling him, I just got left hanging. I was telling him I didn't even know that like this was even in LA. So I'm super happy because I'm gonna bring my dog tomorrow and it's gonna be all good. What's up, y'all?
What's up? Anytime you wanna come on, man.
Got it. I'm gonna be back tomorrow, to be honest.
Sure.
Alright.
Yeah, we'll be out here.
Right. Appreciate the support, man. So we're now at LACMA Lights, and I just posted a Snapchat, and I know I'm talking about all this spiritual stuff today, but I look like my young self, guys. I'm starting to look like I did at 21. Am I, aren't
21.
I? Look at her shirt, guys. Thug life. Well, she didn't see me at 21, so she doesn't know. Let me ask you this though, do I look good?
Yeah.
I put her on this slide. She had no choice. It's on the vlog.
Everything's on the vlog. I just have to answer the right way.
So, okay, off the vlog. Do I look good?
What do you mean?
Off the vlog.
I said yes, and I meant it.
Man, get your own ride home. I'm out.
I said yes, though.
I'm out. Peace. She believes me. I'm out. I'm going to LACMA. Oh God. So we're at LACMA Lights. Because I'm doing the challenge today, me and Ali are going to watch Entourage at 10:10. And I'm excited for it. Steal it. So me and Ali are going to Entourage at 10:10. That means I completed the whole day outside. What I was telling her was, this challenge is a little scary because like, obviously, I have to do this every day, but I can't do this every day. But I also can't stay in my apartment, so you guys are gonna have to figure out a way for me to what to do. Cause obviously, you guys see me a lot happier, but every day though. So I'm back at the Grove to watch Entourage with Ali and the crew. But I am so excited to see this movie, Inside Out. I haven't been excited to see a Pixar movie in so long, and this one I'm juiced for because the characters are the emotions and the feelings in our head. So like, if I were to make a decision, like if I were to yell at Ali, you're a little piece of F for leaving Fousey Tube, the actual character isn't me, it's the thought that's in my head, and me, a guy who lives in my head, can't wait to see that. That's gonna be awesome. All right, guys, we're about to go in the movie. Got Ali.
Got my ticket.
I can fit in this sweater now, by the way.
No way.
I swear.
Do you still have yours?
I look a lot. What?
You look like you're in shape right now.
Say it again.
You look like you're in shape right now.
Wait, I couldn't hear you. Say it one more time.
You look like you're in shape right now.
Yeah, mashallah, man. Mashallah, give me your hands. Mashallah.
Chill.
We're about to go to the movie. I gotta put this away. Bye. So this theater is full of bros. I don't want to say that out loud. But
F-boys.
Ali doesn't realize that he's the biggest F-boy.
Wow.
And he's calling other people F-boys, but I don't want to...
all you guys.
What? Who's the biggest F-boy out of the group?
Oh, him.
Him.
Okay,
look, G!
This is your shirt that I'm wearing.
Oh, wait, the other thing.
I'm not wearing it.
He gave this to me.
But yeah, it's full of like...
I'm like a douchey, but I'm...
Entourage is like a douchey thing. Like, I own all the seasons, I've watched it, and you can tell by the demographics here, it's like pretty douchey.
So we just finished the movie. I absolutely loved it. As a fan of the series, who owns the series and has watched it multiple times, I was smiling ear to ear, and I loved it because it felt like one long episode. How'd y'all like it?
I've seen better. Are you serious?
I mean, so much of it just went over my head.
Like, Ali's lying. He really liked it too.
I liked it.
I was saying, like, so much of it just went over my head because I just didn't get it. Like,
he didn't ever watch an episode, so he had no idea what was going on. But I'm not going to say this. It's not for kids, so any of the kids watching this, don't sneak in. Don't tell your parents I said it was a good movie. But for my grown adults who are a fan of Entourage, I definitely recommend the movie. If you've liked the series, there's no way you're not going to like the movie. It was fantastic, except for the group of Middle Eastern guys behind us who felt the need to be 13-year-old again and yell obnoxious comments throughout the whole movie.
Oh man, it was so hard to not say anything. But
yeah, we were gonna, like, Ali looked back, say something, but they were with like 20
like
people.
They were 10 deep.
So we were like, you know what? Ruin the movie experience. Go ahead.
I jump today.
Yeah, but that was the most annoying stuff ever. Like, that's what I did when I was 13 years old.
That's why I usually avoid movies on opening day.
Yeah.
Because that.
But it was also like Entourage. Like, I expected this was who.
A douchey audience.
Yeah.
Yeah, but middle.
And guess what? You're in that audience.
I had to sit next to them too. You guys.
Oh my God.
I remember one time, like, these two teenagers were acting up like that in the theater. Listen, and this big black guy's like 15 minutes in, hey, shut the f up! And these kids, they were quiet. They were like freaking, like, on another level of quiet. They were so scared. And at the end of the movie, they're like eyeing around. They're looking for this guy because they thought they were going to get jumped, like, on another level. It was beautiful. I loved it. We needed someone like that.
Okay, great story.
Damn, bro. What's wrong with my story?
It's his last day.
Okay, we were going to watch Pitch
He's
Perfect.
He's literally leaving in like 12 hours. I know.
Oh, yeah, dude. What the heck?
All right, my bros, I completed the challenge. I was outside of my house all day today, and I'm exhausted, so I'm not about to edit this vlog. When I don't edit the vlog at night, it means you guys are gonna get the vlog late tomorrow. If I get home and I edit the vlog at night, that means you get the vlog early. So if you ever wonder, why did he upload it at 7 a.m. today? Why did he upload it at 4 p.m. today? It's because nights like these. So it's past midnight right now, I'm about to go to sleep. I'm also not gonna do the jelly bean challenge today because if I do the jelly bean challenge, all the comments are gonna be about the jelly beans, but I feel like this was such a good vlog for me and my mood. I want it to be about that and not about numbers of jelly beans. But just because the challenge isn't today doesn't mean I'm not announcing the winner Friday. So even if I announce the jelly bean challenge tomorrow, the winner is still going to be announced on Friday. So do not even fret, my friends, if that makes sense. So it's not like we missed anything. It's just less of a chance of people to enter. So only the people who do enter will enter. So thank you guys so much for watching another vlog. Today was Tuesday, beautiful day. So happy. And yeah, man, today was really awesome. Really awesome. I love you guys. Give this video a big thumbs up. Especially if you love Dollar. And I'll see you tomorrow. Because you're coming back, right? Oh, lastly, I'm not going to scare you, but I really want to say something. Green tea is green tea if it's just green tea.